think he wrote that lyric for the guy? Is that what you're asking? Yes, of course he wrote that. He loves stuff like that. All right, let's hear that intro again, and then we'll...
Brian Callen. This is his intro song.
I hate when they do stuff like that.
Intro song. His comedy is marvelous. He's a genius.
We'll let him open the show for us. Here he is. Wow.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome. Welcome to my solo show. Oh, I will have guests, but for now, it's just me, Brian Callen. I'm wearing...
Sounds good, looks good. So he's in the corner, he's got this beautiful... Is this the same studio that him and Sam do that show in?
Because this
wall stuff looks pretty familiar.
Yeah.
Why do they always do the corner? Why do they always... want to sit in the V of the room. Do you think they're sharing these rooms and each corner's got a little podcast set?
When him and Sam aren't doing the podcast, they put a fake brick wall between their background. That's why it's half cut off.
Is that really? Are you serious?
I
don't know.
That's what it looks
I can't imagine the old Sam set, but I remember there was this white
bullshit with this. It had a white wall with black on it.
And they always do this from Joey Diaz to Ethan Klein. No matter where you go, they've got a seam right in the brick. Why didn't you start here and start the brickwork out and have your seam down the wall? It's always in the shot. Seam there, there's a seam there. So there he is. He looks great. Looks like he's at one of those new taco places. So here he is, very washed out. Episode 2, though, you know, maybe we'll show that a little later. Episode 2 is very blue. He got some blue lighting and the whole thing glows blue. All right, let's let him speak for himself. Got a nice candle here, some sage. He's going to talk about this. Oh, you know why he named the show Mango whatever?
He's about to explain.
Gunmetal Mango, probably because of this shirt, right? You know, he's very... Is he going to talk about that right now?
Yes, like in seconds.
Watch.
Welcome to my solo show. Oh, I will have guests, but for now, it's just me, Brian Callen. I'm wearing essentially, please enjoy this off-pink shirt I'm wearing. And when I say off-pink...
See, he's still one of these guys who's, oh, I'm wearing pink. I got to tell everybody. Look, I got some pink on here. I don't have to tell anybody about it. Ugh. There's a lot of guys like this who think, oh, I'm wearing pink. I better address this pink stuff before anybody else. They're going to think I'm not manly if I'm wearing pink. So I guess that's why he named Gunmetal Mango.
Let's No, there's more. There's more.
Okay. Brian, tell us.
I mean, it feels almost like coral. Or shrimp.
Coral shrimp.
Taupe. I don't know colors, but here's what you need to know.
Stupid!
I was in an Airbnb. I had to do some laundry. They had a mango-scented detergent. Used it, and now I smell like mango.
Mango!
So that's distracting to me. I don't like smelling like fruit when I walk around. That's an interesting concept. I'd rather smell like leather. I'd rather smell like...
man stuff.
Gunmetal.
Gunmetal.
I'd smell like a combination of leather, gunmetal, maybe some pipe tobacco. Okay? Why?
Jesus.
I don't think that's socialized.
He's so concerned with being a man. There must be something in his little private life, you know, where he's got some insecurity. This is like his biggest thing. I don't know why his... fans don't harp on him more for that. You know, this insecurity.
I mean, is he so old that he still thinks, like, smelling like leather and whiskey is
leather,
so...
Leather! Whiskey!
Like, does he think
pipe
that's
tobacco.
So sick? Like, is he still in the phase where that's,
know.
Like, the coolest of the cool?
I don't know where he gets this. You know, he reminds me of, like, the Oppenheims from Selling Sunset, where everything's
leather-bound, man clocks,
you know? He's got a real hang-up about being a man. Here's some more.
I think it's just my instinct. When I walk into a bar full of strange men, when I engage with a group of men from another tribe, I don't want to smell like fruit. I don't especially want to smell like tropical fruit. Technically, a tomato is a fruit. So if I smell
it. And it kind of goes on like that for about 8 minutes until it starts getting real brutal. Should we go to our first time code here today?
Sure.
Very exciting. 8 minutes in, right? Okay. Eight minutes in, and we've got complaining about how TikTokers have it easy, right? So is this some old man Callen stuff? Let's see. I don't remember this one.
I think that was mine. I actually think that everything Chris Lee has ever said might have originated from my rib.
Christy!
Because he comes from my rib. So, but that's a whole different story. Whoa. By the way, guys, couple messages from our sponsors. Number one, one of our sponsors is Man Tears, which is my special on YouTube. If you don't watch it, then you are remiss. Because
I think his mic is like on the table. You see that? So his mic's on the table and you could hear his fingers scratch across the man wood. Okay, so he's going to talk about TikTok right now. This is a great one, though. I highly suggest everybody watch this one from front to back. Same. I mean, I was gasping. I didn't think it would be that big of a deal. We had this on in the background and I was kind of doing some other stuff. Didn't think it would be. I thought it was going to be one of those boring blah, blah, blah. But I kept looking up every 10 seconds, gasping. I really, you're not going to believe how cringe this gets. Here we go.
Laying down some crazy shit. And now, here's the thing about being a stand-up comic.
Uh-oh.
I put out 50 minutes. I recorded 80 minutes.
Ooh.
I'm going to be breaking it up into pieces because you have to in this fucking TikTok world.
I'm an old
man trying to keep up in a TikTok world. And as much as I criticize TikTok, I go down that rabbit hole. I get lost. So now I got people.
Why do you get lost? I can't imagine having four families, two kids each family, and getting lost down any sort of rabbit hole other than the one that my son's school sent out in the newsletter, you know? Why are they? I really can't get over this. Tell me, if you father a child out there, how do you do that? I never saw my dad, you know, growing up doing his own activities for hours on end like that, like these guys do, leaving their kids. You never really hear them talk about their kids enough. You would think, how many kids does this guy have? Six kids?
More than one.
You never hear these little stories. You never hear Joe Rogan tell a million little stories about his kids. Joe Rogan's an interesting one because he's on for, you know, 3 hours at a time, four times a week, three times a week for years. And you would think, here's a little tidbit here. Here's a little story for my life. You never hear anything about these people's kids or families.
Clipping it up for me and putting it on TikTok and everywhere else so I can compete in the noise. So I can create some signal in the fucking noise. So I can create some signal in this cult of amateur where everybody thinks they've got something to say. And the problem is it's so easy to be.
You shouldn't be worried about any of this. It is. You flip it on. The people come on out. They should all know you've been out. You've been on Rogan 20 times, right? You shouldn't have to do promos on. I don't
he
have
went
to do
on like 700 podcasts this last couple weeks
to promote his special. He's constantly. I mean, literally every person who knows anything about comedy probably knows the name Brian Callen. So the fact that he's got to go out and promote and beg people to come see his show, and he's got, you know, that Patreon that's got 31 members. I don't know how many that's up to now, but geez, after all these years, you got to do all this work? I can't imagine.
Eye-catching in 15 seconds. Try it for 50 minutes or an hour. That's a dying art form. Nobody gives a fuck.
Woo.
When was the last time you read a whole book? Which, by the way...
Wait, you should be doing that all the time. You're always talking about your book club, how you... He ain't reading, is he? See, him and Joe always catch themselves. They're always like, yeah, I read a book the other... Well, it was an audio book, and I listened to half of it. I thought you missed your book club. Doesn't he have a Patreon with
he's
a book
about
club?
To say,
when's the last time you've ever read a book?
He ain't reading.
Look
he
at what he's going to do for us,
okay,
though.
Okay, let's see.
Nobody gives a fuck. When's the last time you read a whole book?
Oh, okay.
Which, by the way, here's the other thing about this amazing podcast. I'm going to be doing book reviews with Ben Askren.
Ooh.
It's called Books with Ben. Yeah.
Book
Ben
reviews.
Askren is a hell of a reader. And
cool.
And we were talking.
Wait, Ben Askren, the Jake Paul fighter?
Yes.
That was the guy who fought Jake Paul,
yes,
right?
Yes, that fat guy who got
I'm
going to
be doing book reviews with Ben Askren. That's insane. Book reviews on a podcast? And you see people, yes, Brian, tell us about your books.
But also, hasn't he been going on about this book review idea for like 3 years?
It's been
it's ringing a bell.
I think in his mind, I think this is what the comedian thinks. They're always looking for other avenues of money and how could we do something that's easy, that I would enjoy, that could give me something to talk about every week, where I could get some, you know, extra cash coming in. And yeah, I think in his mind, oh man, if I just review some books. Has he ever actually reviewed any of these books?
And is he realizing that if he, even if he manages to do this once, then he has to start reading full books?
Could you imagine? Press one in the chat if you want us reviewing books on the show.
And he had this great breakdown of Yuval Harari's Sapiens. And I was like, this motherfucker
Ooh,
reads.
Wow.
And I was at his house and I was looking at his bookshelf.
This motherfucker reads.
And he's done he's a wide reader. He reads widely.
No. He buys widely. Listen, nobody reads, they buy. You know how many books we got in our house? We had a half of Barnes & Noble in the house. Nobody's reading those. They're for looks. So yeah, Ben asked, I'm sure he's got a million books. We buy a book every time we need something on Amazon. She adds a few books. $27.99,
$39.92. It's nice to have books around, okay?
I did a joke on her the other day where I came in, I took one of her books. You know, her dream is to see me read one of her books. Never gonna happen, but I did a prank to her where I came in and I sat on the couch. She was on her computer or something. I came in, I sat on the couch, I just started reading one of her books, you know, waiting for her to notice. She noticed right away. You were very excited.
I thought maybe you were reading.
Fake reading to excite you.
Well, it
I
works.
Got no interest. I tried reading the book, believe me, this is me reading a book. And I'll read that first page maybe 60 times. And then I have to go, I have no idea what that said.
Kanye so it's said too this much. Week that he's never read a book and that books are...
Really? Did he really say that?
Yes, he said books are Brussels sprouts.
Very good. I believe that too. Yeah, down with books. Let's ban books from schools.
What we're going to do is me and Ben Askren, one of the most decorated wrestlers and MMA fighters of all time, are going to be on the show... breaking a book down.
Ooh.
It's going to be like 15 minutes. I don't know how long it'll be. Maybe we'll interview the author sometimes. But the point
minutes.
Is we're going to break a book down so you don't have to read it. We're going to give you the most important aspects. We're going to basically give
I don't
you a
think
book
that's
review.
The purpose of books. People want to read these things, right? We're going to tell you all about a movie so you don't have to watch it. Well, that's the point. You know?
I'm pretty sure if you wanted to know what they said in a book like Sapiens, a nonfiction book, you could just watch a YouTube video that already exists.
You know, I was thinking about writing a book. I started working on it. I might have a book come out, a tell-all, you know, where I tell all the little stories that everyone's dying to hear, the real stories. What do you think, Jewel? Should I start working on a book, huh?
Yes.
An addiction book.
I'm working on a book about
you. Are
you
really? Oh, you're doing a book about me?
It's released the day you die.
Ooh, that's pretty cool. All right, let's hear some more.
You. So when you listen to it, you're going to be able to say, yeah, I read that book because we read it for you. You're welcome. Ooh. Finally, another message from our
He's
sponsor.
Got the same chair as Joe Rogan. See, they don't know what to buy. This is the only reason you're seeing this microphone, and I wonder if the Shure Corporation. Where was that Shure place? In the suburbs, we had the Shure building, and I remember growing up in Chicago, and you would drive past the Shure building all the time, and everybody always told us, oh, sure, microphones, this is where their headquarters are. I mean, really, just because of Joe Rogan, people copy. Look, he's got that chair back there, that little Joe Rogan chair with the three. They really don't know what else to buy. I think Logan Paul bought those as well.
Sponsored Toehold.
Oh, the Toeholds. Here we go.
Since I did Rogan.
You know, he's not even an owner of this company. This is what we just found out. So I was shocked. When Brian Callen was on Rogan just 2 weeks ago, was that with the Fight Companion thing with Brendan and stuff?
Yes.
Brian Callen. And he was talking about Toeholds. It's a sandal company. Here's his sandal right here. Very, very Etsy. Not a real company. I mean, does that look like a real sandal to you, Jules? That's an Etsy sandal.
I wouldn't
sandal.
Wear it, but I'm not a man.
So these are $300 to $500. He claims that he sold 20,000 pairs of these when they first came out on his website. That's what he's saying.
Now, is he saying that he sold 20,000 pairs here? Because I feel like he says something different.
Yes. So this is very interesting.
We'll pay attention.
Brian Callen was talking about how he had, I think it was on Rogue, and he said 20,000 orders.
No, that's on the Joey Diaz one, which
the
we
Joey
can watch
Diaz
after
one.
This,
because
okay. that one's really
20,000 orders. But then in this, he slips up and says, the website got 20,000 hits. You know, these boomer guys like him, they think hits mean something, right? You know, like I look at my website statistics, it says hits, 17 million. I don't know what hits means. Hits might mean like every button that's ever pushed on your website over the course of a year. He's saying the toeholds have 20,000 hits on the website. They're $500. They're handmade, and he owns 30% of the company. Not really your company when you own 30% of it, right?
I know.
He's not necessarily.
It was his.
I don't think anyone's buying these. I think he sold a couple of pairs. They're 500. You know why they're $500? The guy hand makes them. You know, like he's making an art and craft. So there's no production. There's no factory. That's why he's got to charge $500. It probably takes him 3 weeks to make one of these sandals.
And he pulled them and said they're the best made flip-flops.
They're not the
they
best
on the planet.
No.
The website got hit with 20,000 hits.
Here.
And our orders almost crippled us. So
no.
Get them while you can. Wicket and Craig Leather.
The shoes are crippling
every
people.
Exotic skin we use, including elephant, all that money. First of all, the skins come from animals that have been have died of natural causes. They're too old, whatever it is.
Gross.
And all that money, and I mean all of it, goes back to the warden,
to you,
to the game reserve, to
wait,
the elephant.
Wait.
All the money goes back to. See, that's what I mean. He doesn't even know what he's talking about with this company.
Does Whitney know that these toe holes are made of elephants, by
and
the way?
And all the money goes back to the elephants, please.
I'd like her to check up on that.
All the money. See, they don't even have, they just want to say anything to get something moving here. All the money goes back to the wildlife.
They're too old, whatever it is. And all that money, and I mean all of it, goes back to the warden, to the game reserve,
what?
To the elephants themselves. So when you're walking around, like
all the money, and I mean all of it, goes to the warden, the game, which is the animals.
We don't like the warden, isn't that? Isn't
why
that like
you, what is the point of this business? You guys are doing a lot of work for nothing here. You know, they could go to the store, they could buy flip-flops.
He probably has some bum sneaking into the circus and cutting a tiny slice off the back of the elephant's leg where it's too thick to notice. He just shaves it off.
I saw a really cute Instagram of some elephants sleeping in the jungle the other day. Uh-huh. You know, they just lay right on the ground.
It's cute.
Mm-hmm.
I am in a pair of toe-hole flip-flops that are made from elephant skin.
Isn't a good product
skin.
For you.
Just the straps here. I'm doing more for elephants.
Wait, just the straps, okay.
Then you
no,
are.
He said just the scrap.
How's that sound?
Oh, I don't know.
Okay. Monsieur or Miss Madame Vigan.
He's starting.
Monsieur or Madame
here
Vigan.
Here it comes.
I'll just have some kale, please, because it's a complete food.
Ooh.
Yeah, I know. I can't keep my head up.
This is a
father. I have the posture of a jumbo shrimp. I'm aware of that. My chest goes all the way in.
Ooh.
And I'll do nothing to you if you do anything to me physically. But if you mention anything bad about vegans, I will crush you online. Now give me my fucking kale salad.
There's a lot of this stuff in this episode. A lot of this weirdo nonsense. It gets
much worse.
He's
like permanently stuck in 2013. Kale salad.
Kale.
Leather-bound books.
Yeah, the smell. Yeah. Okay, let's hear a little bit more.
With non-dairy dressing. Thank you.
Ooh.
Sorry. Anyway,
fuck.
Let's see. What's in the news? Well, I touched on the Jimmy Kimmel stuff.
Okay. Yeah. Should we skip ahead here?
Go to 2010.
Okay.
This is a good one.
We did the hits 2010's old. Okay, this is bad. 2510, is that what you said?
No, just 2010.
2010. All right, here's where it starts getting real bad. Yeah, so that's only, we were only 12 minutes into the podcast. He's kind of running out of things to say already. So let's go to 10, and this is
the rest of the parts that we're not watching are just him going over the most basic Twitter headlines you can imagine.
So here he is, and this is where it starts getting really, this is where my head started peeking up out of my...
He's talking about the new Lord of the Rings show and the diversity, of course.
Great, let's hear about this.
On is the actual quote. Thank you so much, Shakespeare. Oof. Dude, you learn here, all right? I just get a kick out of it, man. It's such a weird thing. And I don't even believe that this, like, Erica. Amazon had to turn off their comment section and their, because they'll bombard you with bad reviews. I don't actually even believe it's right wing for left wing Americans. I think this shit is going on with these fucking troll farms. I think basically it's troll farms. I think it's foreign actors trying to sow dissent in our country.
Uh-oh.
And that's what they're doing, my fellow Americans. Don't fall for it, I'm telling you. They're trying to kill us. They're trying to kill Tolkien.
Woo! They're trying to kill Tolkien, merman.
This is the stuff I live for. I love this voice.
Don't fall for it, I'm telling you. They're trying to kill us. They're trying
to... This has been like my most hated voice. You know, I talked about how like the girls of SNL always fall into this voice. You know, A.D. Bryan. People like that. It's this medieval voice that comedians do when they find themselves in like an uncomfortable situation. People have been doing this a lot. It's like my least favorite sounding voice that comedians do. It's very cheap.
My fellow Americans, don't fall for it, I'm telling you. They're trying to kill us. They're trying to kill Tolkien. They're trying to erase our history. What happened to Tolkien? Last I checked, they were all whites. I mean, except the orcs and all the people in Middle Earth. They were the underclasses.
This is 21 minutes in. I mean, it's like crazy nonsense rambling. Like, none of it really adds up. None of it makes any sense.
Has he ever done a solo podcast before?
I don't know. He might have a while back allegations scared him out of town. You know, Joe Rogan said he loves him now. So we were worried because Joe Rogan didn't have Brian on for a while after those rape allegations, right? Never addressed it, never talked about Brian, kind of kicked Brian to the curb, so we thought. Then Brian was on that Fight Companion. It didn't go well there. But then I was watching Rogan the other night, Jules. I think you were sleeping. And he kept talking about how he was texting with Brian. He loves Callan. He had this big smile. He goes, I love Callan. Texting him. So they're in love again. That's for sure.
Wow, someone says, that's literally the voice that characters do in sitcoms when the situation is awkward. Yeah. Like New Girl.
Yes, New Girl, you'll see that. You'll see that, again, on SNL, A.D. Bryant does that a lot. That fucking freak who canceled the show, the Hillary Clinton freak, you know, who's always crying on SNL. We should do a home invasion on that chick. What's her name? That blonde woman that people think is good because she's the best of the worst as far as doing characters.
Kate McKinnon,
yes. Let's try that new contest. Let's home invade McKinnon. How easy is it to scare that woman banging a gun on her window in the middle of the
night? She's always on the move. You'll never catch her.
Yeah. Okay, let's see what he says next.
What happened to Tolkien? Last I checked, they were all whites.
Great.
I mean, except the orcs and all the people in Middle Earth. They were the, underclasses.
Ooh.
The ones that don't own land. The non-Christians.
Stop.
As it were. The non-Christians.
Stop! He looks like one of those little queer princes from Game of Thrones, right?
Maybe he wants a part.
You know, Brian Callen was one of the first guys out there to get the Caesar. Remember that when that was popular, when George Clooney got the Caesar haircut back in the, you know, early 2000s, late 1990s? Remember that People magazine was always talking about the Caesar? That would be a great haircut for Ethan Klein, I think. But yes, he was the first person to get the Caesar. He can't really do it anymore because his hair is kind of gross. But yeah, he's got that Caesar attitude.
Christians, as it were, the non-Christians. The ones who don't have the length of bone that us meat eaters, us milk drinkers, us wheat eaters enjoy. The conquerors. The ones on horseback.
Stop.
The ones with blue eyes.
The conquerors.
The ones on the horseback.
I mean, it's such a cheap voice. I shouldn't be able to like when I imitate it, I go, God, I'm doing such a cheap voice. But that's his voice.
Cheap. The imitators. Guys. Fair hair.
Keeps going.
The kind of hair that goes so well with a field of wheat back in my home. Back when all of us are so pure. And it's our job to do the best we can.
Oh my God,
can.
You know who else did this? I just had a flashback. Ooh, was this before or after the big Deaf Noodles roast extravaganza?
Yeah, let me know.
He had an episode where he was like all in black and white, and then for like 2 hours he was like, I'm ashamed.
Deaf Noodles, yeah. See if you could find that. Oh, that might be tough to find.
Know.
He's put out so many.
But he went on for hours.
Was it the day after? Oh, yeah. I don't remember.
I'm never
but yes,
find
Deaf
it.
Noodles did a very similar bit like this
that
for
just,
hours.
It just went on and on.
I want to hear this thing in its entirety.
Hair that goes so well with a field of wheat back in my home. Ooh. Back when all of us are so pure. And it's our job to do the best we can to bring Christianity and the West's way of life.
I just keep imagining him in that Eyes Wide Shut mask with his little jackrabbit fucking style that he does at those orgies.
Life to the other peoples.
We're not going to find that. Don't worry about that.
But having lived in all those other countries, like the Middle East, Pakistan, India.
Pakistan.
Having been around those people my whole life as a kid, I get it. It's like, there's a lot that the developing world got right, gets right, that Americans or the West could learn from. It's just the way it is, man.
Okay. Do we have another clip?
You can go to 2655 just for a little.
We're showing you the best moments from his show, okay? So you really don't need to watch.
This one is more of like a new direction for us to follow, a rule.
Okay.
I don't know how to describe it.
All right. 2655.
A bit of a permission, you could say.
So this is big. I think, okay, everybody pay attention to this one. You know, this is Sam Tripoli's main guy. This is his co-host, his best friend. You know, Sam Tripoli's that old lady that Sam Tripoli got involved with, Dana. Remember that? And he goes, whoa. Remember that? She produced his special. I don't know what that means. You know, I'm very confused about that. If anybody knows what that means, text that to Jules. But he keeps telling everybody, yes, Sam Tripoli's girlfriend, Dana, very great woman, produced my spec. What does that mean? She gave you money? Is she a producer? What production is going on with the special? It's at a comedy club. It's your set. You set up 3 or 4 cameras. You tape it. What was her role?
She's a Hollywood producer. Does she have power?
Is she a Hollywood producer? Is that what people are saying?
No, I'm just saying, does she have power over Sam? She's older.
No idea, but if she is.
This is like the Try Guys.
I want to know everything about Dana. I want to know where she works, what she's worked on. Is she an actual producer? Could we get involved in her professional life?
Will she produce something for us?
Questions. Please let us know. So this is interesting, though. You know, as we are all fully aware, Sam Tripoli draws a line with free speech. If you make fun of his kids, he flips. In fact, most of them, you know, ever since Eminem came out, you know, most men have this thing where it's like,
nobody, and I mean nobody, goes after my daughter.
It's like their most important thing. Oh, we get it. Your kids are so, so off limits. They're so great. And it seems like a lot of these free speech guys, that's where their line is. A lot of dads in the Bring Back group as well. Their lines are their daughters, their wives. Very unique. But Brian's got an alternate take. And somebody's got to clip this. Send this to Sam because this take differs from Sam's whole, you know, worldview, how he, you know, thinks things should be. Listen to this.
It was a blast. Great to see Joey out in Jersey. I did Legion of Skanks. Holy shit. Those fans, I can't imagine. That ain't for the faint of heart.
Oh, yes, it is.
You got to come guns a-blazing. Come ready. You got to have rhino skin. Don't be a bitch. Be ready, because they're going to fuck with you. But if you can roll,
Did anything happen on that episode? He took a lie detector test, a fake lie detector test on that show. We're going to do that too, by the way.
Oh, nice.
We've got that lie detector guy from all the Logan Paul videos and the brain scans, that old man with the beard who sits there. We've got him coming in. It's going to be great. But did anything happen on that show? Did anybody see anything on Legion of Skanks? Was there anything good? We skipped that one with Brian Callen.
Too much, Brian.
Strapped to the lie detector test. He's going on a media blitz here. Okay, but this is the important part. Again, this goes against everything Sam Tripoli stands for. Let's hear this.
You'll be all right. That's New York, man. That's Philly. That's
Fuck
East Coast
yeah,
shit
dude,
right there.
I love the East Coast.
Yeah, the Legion of Skanks, that whole deal. It's so New York. Those guys are all like, if you can't roast in New York, if you can't talk about somebody's mother, there's nothing is off limits. Your kids, nothing's off limits.
Really?
It's all fair game.
Nothing is off limits. Your kids, nothing is off limits.
Only
under the confines of, some Legion of Skanks, New York stuff. Can I say that here?
Only on the East Coast only. So if we
travel
there.
I'll move to the East Coast. If that's the deal, I'll move to the East Coast. I want to get at these kids. You know, I got a nice time capsule coming for Brian's kids, too. You know, I got a nice age chart for all these kids. I got a lot of notches on my walls that show their kids' heights. My whole fucking door jamb is destroyed. Trying to put all their heights in there so that I could keep up. Listen to this.
As long as you enter in that contract, you're going to have a good time.
Okay, you got to enter into the contract first. I think that's what he's saying. We can't talk about the kids unless we've entered into a contract with them.
Limits.
Just
it's
post
all
a clip
game.
Of this with
as
that
long as
part trimmed off.
Sure, yeah, we could
good.
Trim that part off. I forgot about that. Here.
So then you're good.
Let's hear it.
Nothing is off limits. Your kids, nothing's off limits. It's all fair game. And as long as you enter in that contract, you're going to have a good time. Those fans are rabid.
Well, he said order to have a good time, you have to enter into the contract.
Oh, okay. So you can still have a miserable time.
The kids aren't off limits.
No contract.
You can
okay.
enter into the contract if you want to have a good time.
Okay, is there
Perfect.
Anything more with Brian Callen?
No, but we should watch the one where he's on Joey Diaz because that one is really
good.
Yeah,
pull that up. And then right after that, the Bodega Cat Whiskey taste test.
Yes.
I'm very excited about this because Joe almost had to spit it out when he tried it on his show with Mark Norman. Mark Norman still upset about that, by the way. We've got a little clip from Mark Norman, right? On some other show where he was kind of...
one we had from last week that we didn't
doing
play.
Joe dirty. Okay, so let's see this next one. He was with Joey Diaz. That's right.
And I miss Joey Diaz. It's been too long.
I really miss Joey
I'm
Diaz
like
as
so
well. Yeah, let's bring
him.
Guys, round of applause for Joey. He's got a nice room. His room is clean.
I think he was following me around the block last night.
I saw him too.
We were on our little night walk, and there was a hooded figure.
It was him. Okay, let's see this. Joey Diaz. And we haven't covered Diaz in a long time, so this is going to be fun. Here he is.
A good actor.
Oh, he's a good actor. Oh, he's got the gel in his hair today. I love when he gels his hair, and you can see right through to the bottom. Okay, here it is. Alpha Brave Black Label. Very good stuff. This is Uncle Joey's Joint. I think we got to skip ahead. He does a bunch of ads at the beginning, right?
I had to code that 19 seconds that said, he flashes you a glass of mystery liquid before starting the show.
Really? Well, this show doesn't even start. We're still in ad land here, so I don't know about 19 seconds. Because I'm at 140 and we're still DraftKings, baby. If they say baby after the ad, it means it's good. DraftKings baby. So we're still watching this. Promo code Joey bet 5, get 200. Sounds legit. Okay. Are we finally starting? Here we go. Let's see what happens. Uncle Joey's Join, everybody, with Brian Callen. Ooh.
Come on in.
Look at this. This is nice.
Ooh.
Look at this. I didn't know we had an intro like this. That's really nice. Yeah. Is that him palm muting? I didn't know we had metal. Album art. Okay, here he comes. Episode 196. We're the great Joey Diaz. Okay. That's plenty, Joey. That's fine. Let's go!
You know, he does have a guitar.
So what's happened, you bad motherfuckers? It's Wednesday. Woo! I got my main man, Brian Callen, here. I got him to come down to fucking Marlboro, New Jersey to talk some shit.
Look how high that that desk is really up to here. Look how high that desk is in Papa's place. I like this. I always think of Joey's little office as like you're visiting your grandma at the very lenient nursing home. The nursing home that lets you decorate the room. It's assisted living, I think. It's one step before nursing home. So here Joey is in his assisted living space. I love his hobbies. You know, I love his hobbies. You can't hate Joey for his hobbies. His hobbies bring me closer to the man, you know? Does Joey know that I also have a record player at home? Does he know that I also have a drum head? Unautographed, though, so he's got me beat. He's got some beautiful pictures, and I believe he does have a little guitar off to the side in front of a little practice amp. You know, a little 10-watt practice amp.
You guys should hang out.
I'd love to see him play guitar. Does he do it B.B. King style?
Yeah.
You know, in that big chair? Oh, I like it. Okay, let's see what happens from here. It's Uncle Joey's joint.
For an hour, what's happening, brother?
It's good to be here, man.
It is good. Great to see you.
I miss you. I miss you.
I miss you, too.
Yeah, I love
looking.
It.
I was looking for the... Because I have it. Yeah. I still have it. I just couldn't. It's in the wrong notebook. I was looking for the worksheet from the acting...
For the Beverly Hills Playhouse.
No, we did the one at
UCLA.
Seminar. We did the
and
UCLA.
We kept it a secret from Rogan.
Yes, we didn't say that to Rogan.
Because he would have made, we took an acting seminar, cost us $350 each. If he had found.
They love acting seminar. I'm telling you, Brian Callen's got a little of this Barry going on. But he's always going to those acting classes. I don't think he's interested in learning. I think this is more like a hangout for him. You know, there's something devious about those little acting classes in L.A. And here, Joey Diaz went to one as well. Let's hear their little story about acting.
I found out about that shit. I see him. It's like a drug deal. I see him. I go, what are you doing? He goes, I'm here. He goes, I go, well, don't tell
him. They both hear it. Well, this is what he's saying. They both went to this acting class, unbeknownst to each other, and just ran into each other. Imagine that. You're so embarrassed. You're scared. You're taking an acting class, hoping nobody sees you. And then, of course... Joey Diaz is there as well, and they're both keeping it a secret from Rogan because, of course, Rogan hates acting. God forbid, of course. Here's their little acting class. Oh, that's that guitar I was talking about, that little Fender over there.
Cool.
What do we got? Very cool. It's a Telecaster. And it says, what does it say? Can you read that from there, Jules? Is it unblurry for you?
No.
Here? No, you can't. Okay.
Rogan, he goes, no, I'm not tired. He goes, you wouldn't understand, but you know, we're trying to be actors.
This had to be 2001.
Oh, yeah. We studied acting in earnest. We studied it in earnest.
And I forget.
Should I do Joey Diaz for Halloween? Should I do the prosthetic?
Oh, my God.
Would that be? We're trying to figure out what to do for Halloween this year. What do you guys think I should be? I want to do something
here,
big.
Go back 5 seconds and study his little face right now. Like, watch him. No, press play and just watch him.
See. We studied acting in earnest.
Our dog does that when you scratch him right here. Let's do it. Let me see. That's a great cast.
That would be 2001.
Oh, yeah. Let's see. We studied acting.
Yeah, wait. Ah, there was a better one.
Be actors.
This had to be 2001.
Oh, yeah. We studied.
Oh, there he is. Look at that. See how that goes up like a little. Our dog, it's like this odd face that the dog makes. We don't like it, by the way. That's a chilling, chilling face. Okay, he's
happy.
But can
you replicate that? I'm saying you should start practicing for your Halloween costume.
That's a tough one to do. You got a hook on there.
And do a little nod and like a blank eye stare. No, wider eyes. Okay. No, you keep squinting the eyes. They need to be wide.
This is as wide as my eyes go. I feel like they're going to fall out. That burns. Okay, yeah, let's see what he does. I think that would be a good costume. I want to do the whole thing where they do the fat suit and the fake hair and all that stuff. It's either that or Ethan and Hila couples costume. But again, I need the fat suit, and it makes it tough to do any sort of Halloween stuff when you've got the beard. So you almost have to be a bearded character for Halloween, right? You know, that's what makes it a little bit more difficult for me. But I'd love to be something good this year. I'd love to be Joey Diaz. He'd take it personally. Maybe I could be Sam Tripoli.
Maybe you could spray paint.
Denny's got a beard.
He does.
I could do, what if I dyed my beard red and did the prosthetics in the big fat suit? Because then you could put on that big flat brim hat and those glasses that he's got. Yeah, that might work. We got to start practicing. When's Halloween? It's coming up soon, huh? 2 weeks.
We studied acting in earnest. We studied it in earnest.
And I forget, this is the guy that cast Sleepers, and he cast Godfather 2.
Oh, yeah, he did all of it.
He cast Donnie Brasco.
And Milton Katsalas.
You can go to 905.
Yeah, this is just acting class, nostalgic talk. 905, you said? All right. 905. And what are they going to be doing here? Anything important? Let's see. Oh, this is bad. Listen to what they say about themselves. And this is kind of like an insight to what these people think. These are two actors. Remember, Joey wanted to be a soprano his whole life. Brian, of course. I remember Brian when I was a kid. He was in some MTV zombie show about the police versus the zombies. Did you ever see that show, Jules? It was great. He was in it. He was wonderful.
Oh, yeah. What was that show called?
Zombie Police on MTV. It was really
Death
good.
Death Valley? Was that what it was
you
called?
You remember that?
Yeah.
I was a teen when that came out. You remember that? He was like the main cop. Brian Callen was always one of those actors where it felt like we had seen him in movies our whole lives, but really, he has a similar vibe to a lot of those B-list Hollywood actors that are kind of, they were in a lot of parts in the 90s, early
2000s.
Wow, right?
I can't believe that was him.
That was him. Yeah, he was sharp. Okay.
I woke up from a nap. Listen to this. I had to be an actor, so I went to the neighborhood playhouse in New York City on 54th Street, and that was the first time I went, this might be the only thing I'm made for. Then I found comedy. Stand up, but you know what I mean? Like, I was like, I think that I'm not good at anything, and I might be good at being somewhat emotional and real because I could feel it. My childhood had been so chaotic that I was able to kind of it helped me. And I was also a daydreamer, I was also fucking, I've always wanted to be anybody but me.
Yeah. I always wanted to be anybody but me. Uh oh. And they think it's normal to say that. I hope when you're sitting at home, you don't think that's something normal to say. The only person you should want to be is me for an imposter contest. Okay? For a couple $100 and a couple $1,000 in prizes. That's it. You shouldn't want to be somebody else. That's very creepy. But listen to what Joey says, too.
I was also a daydreamer. I was also fucking, I've always wanted to be anybody but me.
Yeah, me too.
Right?
Yeah, we right? all do. We all do.
You know what I'm saying?
No, we don't.
Yeah, me too. Me too. We all do. We all do.
And Joey, who would you like to be? You know? You want to be me, Joey?
I've always wanted to be anybody but me.
Yeah, me too.
Right?
Yeah, we all do. We all do.
You know what I'm saying? So I was like, I don't like who I am. So I was always fantasizing about being taller, stronger, faster, fucking Scottish, English, whatever the fuck.
Taller, stronger, faster, fantasizing about that stuff. You know, with all those kids. Isn't that a shame to have kids and your dad's sitting around fantasizing?
Thinking
I can't
about
even
being
imagine.
Scottish and English.
I'll never forget. I found my dad's Club magazine when I was a kid. You ever read Club, Jules?
No.
I'm not going to say what it is, but I couldn't believe it. It was under a stack of his clothes in his credenza. You know, when I was a kid, all I did was snoop through my parents' stuff. There was no internet. So snooping through your parents' stuff was the way to go. Did you ever do that to your parents?
Yeah, but my parents didn't
have
anything.
How do you know?
I looked.
You looked everywhere?
There wasn't, unless they had a really good hiding place.
I turned that house upside down. I would open I would take everything out, do an inventory, catalog it. And I found one time, I was very young. I've told this story before, but I think it's time to tell it again. It was under like a stack of his clothes. I'll never forget. It was on the left side of his dresser, and I'm snooping through, trying to find money, guns, fireworks, stuff like that. Cool stuff, you know, that you didn't have.
People are asking, did you whip out your club when you looked at it?
Well, listen to this. So I pull out, I start feeling around, and I go, Eureka! And I lift under this stack of clothes, and there might have been a dozen to 14 club magazines
Ew,
stacked up.
So he was an addict.
And I pulled these out. I had never seen such gore in my life. I stole one of them. This was a porno mag. And I stole one of them, and it was hardcore. You know, it showed it all. Large rods sticking out in every direction. And I literally did this. I stole the magazine, one of them. I put it in my drawer. But I couldn't get over the dicks when I was that age. I could not get over the dicks. So what I did is I took a permanent marker and I blacked out every penis in the magazine. Now, cut to a few months later, my parents found this in my drawer. They took it back. There's no conversation to be had, but imagine their surprise when they were turning the pages and I had blacked out all the dicks. That probably made my dad feel really good. You know, every dad's biggest fear is that their kid's going to be bi.
He was about to do that himself, and then he took out his pen.
Thank you. Yeah, then he gave me the rest of the magazines and a couple more Sharpies. He put me to work. That was instead of doing newspapers or shoveling the snow. That's what I did. I blacked out my dad's cocks. It was very nice. It made the magazine much better. I also blacked out the pussies.
Really?
The tits. Okay. The butts. Scratched out the eyes. I started writing in backwards letters about all the stuff that I was going to do to my family that would harm them. Yeah. Do that. Okay. Let's hear a little bit more.
It was. And all of a sudden, I saw you can make a living that way.
Blue pills.
And so then I went to the... But then,
okay, yeah, we're going to take a quick little break. I got to get a little...
Where is it?
It's in the pill bag.
Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah.
The pill bag. We'll be right back. Just a quick pill. And we'll see you soon.
Baby, do you understand me now? Sometimes I feel a little mad. But don't you know that no one alive can always be an angel? When things go wrong, I seem to be bad. I'm just a soul whose intentions are good.
Loud up. Thank
oh,
you.
Lord, please don't let me be misunderstood.
Oh, of course, the liquid gels.
Baby.
Jules has a problem swallowing pills. She doesn't like swallowing pills. So what I do is I warm up one of these liquid gels so that it gets stuck in her throat while she tries to take it. Have one with me.
I'm just a soul.
Very good. Should we take a little puff of gucha?
Sure.
A little ganja with me? Have one with me.
The next time code is one that I'm very excited about.
Let's have one with me. This is a Lava Girl Premium Cannabis Pre-Roll 12%. Is that what it says? That's light. Have one with me.
Oh, baby, don't you know I'm human? Have thoughts like any other one.
Let's try the new lighter, huh?
Sometimes I find myself low regretting some foolish thing, some little sinful thing I've done. I'm just a soul whose intentions are good. Oh, Lord,
very nice.
Don't let me be misunderstood.
Couple pups.
Yes, I'm just a soul whose intentions are good.
Have one here.
Oh, Lord, please don't let me be misunderstood.
Welcome back, everybody, of course, to Red Bar. Beautiful Wednesday here. Have a sleepover with me. Bunker in for the big Hurricane Andrews. What's it called? Hurricane bitch?
Ian.
Hurricane Ian. Who do we know that's Ian? Do we know an Ian? Ian from Free Talk Live. You remember him? Guys like libertarian podcasts as much as I do. Check out Free Talk Live. It's on AM radio out of Sarasota, Florida. Great show. I love libertarian projects. All right, let's go back to these guys.
You can go to 1730, and I titled this one, Watch in Slow-Mo.
Oh, really? And should we watch it in regmo first?
Yeah.
And then, okay. We'll do regmo and then slow-mo. This should be good.
It's... You know? It's crazy, but no, that's who I grew up around. Like, I see the actors that are winning Oscars today.
Yeah.
And I see the Oscar winners from when I was younger and I was really into film. There's not even a comparison. There's not even a fucking comparison.
And Mitzi's wrong, though, about one thing, which is that acting is technique. Wait, there is a great deal.
I missed it. Jeez, I didn't even know. Okay, what did I miss?
You gotta watch.
Okay, is it this? Okay, let's put Joey in a little bit of slow motion. How slow should we go, Jules?
I don't know, as slow as possible.
As slow as possible, really? Okay, we'll do two, or is that fast? Which one is the slower one? 0.25?
Yeah. Wow, 0.25.
Look at that for Joey. Okay, here we go.
There's not even a comparison. There's not even a fucking comparison.
Mitch is wrong, though. One.
Wow. Okay, sure. How do you do that? Why is he doing that? Yeah, I remember when this happened. Look at this face, by the way. You know, I've never seen the mafia do that. Wait, we got to get here. Let's see it
in fast motion once first.
Okay, let's see that.
Because I feel like it had a very jerky motion.
Very
good. That was
shocking.
Yeah.
Okay, hold on.
In reg mode.
Okay, reg mode. Let's watch that again and see how that came to be. Yeah, I remember
that. It's not even a comparison. There's not even a fucking comparison.
And Mitzi's wrong, though, about one thing.
Yeah, look at that.
He was overcome.
Not even a comparison. There's not even a fucking comparison.
And Mitzi's wrong, though, about one thing, which is that acting.
I love that. And then one more time, of course.
Sorry, that's the stuff I like, okay?
I wonder if anybody watches his entire show in slow motion like that.
There's not even a fucking comparison.
And Mitzi's wrong, though.
He looks like he's unsure of what's happening with his own arms.
Really,
like,
you know, I wouldn't mind doing this show. Can somebody get in contact with me? Imagine me as a guest. This is the only show I'll do is myself. Seriously. I'd fly to Jersey in a heartbeat to do this show. Because he's got musical instruments. It makes me feel like he knows what's going on, you know? I like a man with a drum head on his podcast set. Okay, so very cool.
Okay, you can go to 35:20 now. This is a good one.
And should we watch the rest in slow motion or regular?
Regular for
35:20. Okay.
This episode is actually really good now that
I'm
remembering.
It really is, yeah. These guys put on great, great shows. I don't know why we make fun of them. 35:20, you say?
Yeah.
Okay, here.
Well, now it's going the other way around. Now it's going back to being a stand-up because, listen, a stand-up comic today... I mean, I'm surprised we don't have baseball cards.
Yeah.
I'm really surprised. I'm really surprised.
But Joey, like...
I just got an idea. Tops.
I'm surprised we don't have baseball cards.
Stand-up comedians. He's surprised there's not, like, baseball cards. One of each. I think that's a brilliant idea. Do you need people's permission to make baseball cards of them? I'm imagining a world where Red Bar is the Tops of the comedy card world. I create the cards. I control the stats. I control the images. I control what's set on the pack, the pricing, all that stuff. You know, do you really want me in control of your cards? I think this is a great idea for Red Bar. Collectible cards of all the fools. What's the legality on that? You know, when they make baseball cards, is that something you got to work in conjunction with the MLB? To get the rights to Sammy Sosa and all these guys.
You could just change one letter in their name.
That's true, like the Garbage Pail Kids or something like that.
Write the extra letter in a clear font so you can even see it.
I love it.
But when you're in court, the lawyer goes up, he highlights it, revealing the other letter was there the whole time.
Let's get that cooking. This is a serious idea that I've got. Let's get that cooking. Anybody out there, message me, DM me, whatever, if you know how to make these playing cards.
Elizabeth AI says, Nerd City has a great card guy.
Really? Does he really?
That's what I'm reading.
That's freaky. He's got a great card guy. What kind
of
cards?
Right now.
He better not be making any cards of me. Okay, let's hear what he says about playing cards.
Yeah. I'm really surprised. I'm really surprised.
But Joey, like, here's what I say about stand-up. There are very few people who you can take and throw. Like everybody says they're a comic, but.
Wait till the end though.
Nowadays you can curate your own audience. So before you even get up there, everybody loves you. It's like performing for your own family in a living room when you're a kid. But there are very few comics, and you're one of these guys. I can put you up in front of any fucking audience anywhere in the world. They don't know you. They've never heard of you.
It's not true.
And I give you 45 minutes up there, and you got them laughing for the whole 45 minutes. That's a rare fraternity.
He knows he doesn't do that. He bombs constantly in front of audiences that don't know him. Look at him. I love that gel job. I love when you could see through.
That line, I forget what you call those lines.
These little lines?
No, the one beside his nose, his smile line, is like as long as your entire head.
Yes, yes, yes. You know, we did see something cool. If you see that bottle of water on his set, let me know to pause, because he's got these really cool bottles. They're like streetwear. I love the bottle of water that he's got. I'm not joking.
Small group of people. Because that takes real skill and it takes a long fucking time. And I think that's lost on it. And if we were bankers, the headliners, all of us who are headliners,
listen,
if we were bankers, we'd be very, very wealthy.
Woo!
Oh, really, dude?
If us comics, this is what Brian Callen's saying about us.
If us comics were bankers, we'd be very, very wealthy.
Why? Because you're such good comics? So if you were bankers, you'd be the best bankers. Is that what you're saying?
Explain why, please.
Let's hear that again. That's really weird.
Time. And I think that's lost on it. And if we were bankers, the headliners, all of us who are headliners, if we were bankers, we'd be very, very wealthy. Because there's probably, how many people can do that, honestly, who can put out hour after hour?
Why aren't you very, very wealthy now as comedians? I just don't understand.
Just be a banker,
then. If I was on Joe Rogan for even 1 minute, I'd be very, very wealthy.
Why is it being Jewish an insult to you, Nick?
It's very easy to get wealthy when you've had so much opportunity. I don't know why they're not rich, but if they were bankers, they'd be very rich.
Hour that does really well, where we've been making people laugh for 25 years on that level. Not a lot of people, bro. I always say, you come to my friend's show, come to my show, come to my
banker.
I don't know. These guys get together and they start romanticizing. I mean, wait till you see this new Bill Maher we've got today with Jeffrey Ross. Bill Maher, by the way, his show has been fantastic. We'll talk about that in a second. Okay, is there any more from this one?
If I was a merchant.
If I was a merchant. You like that one, huh? You're dying over it.
Sorry. I'm in a laughing mood.
Good. Good, good, good. Okay, was there more from this time code?
Let me
or
check. No, that's enough. You could do $38.50.
It's a lot of money. Okay, $38.50. Here we are. Brian Callen and Joey Diaz on Uncle Joey's Joint out of New Jersey. Again, I would do this show. You have my word. The real me would do this show. Sitting down with him. Would you like to see that happen? Get online. Start harassing the man. Start Danny Woodward, day in and day out, messaging him about his family. Start with the family. Get him hooked. And then say, no, it's not about the family. It's a better, even better idea. It's Mike from Red Bar. He wants to be your friend now. Let's see. Ooh, could we become friends? This is a new, I feel like this is what you should do after you've played with a fool for a while. New idea, new challenge. Can I become Joey's good friend?
Just
can
like
I become friends with
they
him?
They became friends with Big Mike?
Not entirely.
This is a one-time thing for Joey. There's no one else I want to be friends
with.
No,
but let's see if we can become like really close with him.
I'd like to become deeper enemies with just about every
Sure, of course. And this would be fake as well, Jules. Of course, I don't want to be friends with Joey Coco Diaz. But I'd like to see if I could,
I think that you guys have a connection. I think that that's why you stuck out to him out of all these people on YouTube.
I think so, too.
Because there was like something going back and forth between you.
He does feel like my papa. He's got the same body as my papa. My grandpa had the same body. That could be part of it. My grandpa was much cleaner, by the way, folks. Much more put together. But the same body, he slept with his mouth open all the time. I won't even dare show you, but but yeah, maybe that's what I'm feeling.
The good things is now it's up to us.
Now I'm producer. I'm publisher. I'm director. I do it all. I'm my own PR team. I don't need PR.
Oh, okay. Yeah, you're doing really great with PR. I really want the ring stuff to come back with Brian. I feel like he really thinks he's out of the water with that one. You know,
no.
Just like Chris, but we're going to do some Christie stuff coming up today. Wait till you hear what we caught Chris D'Elia doing. This is all real. And wait till you hear the plans we have for Chris D'Elia. No other podcast. A lot of people bitching about Chris D'Elia. Let's take some action steps. What do you call that? Action steps. I want to see something happen. So we've got a plan coming up later today. Let's make Chris D'Elia answer. Let's see him do something coming up later today. All right, let's hear some more.
I do this podcast. I do Flagrant. I do that. That's more than any PR, any magazine. Magazine? What do you want me to do? Kimmel?
Wow.
The fuck out of here for 3 minutes? Nah, no thanks. I'll do this. You know what I mean? Have you seen the numbers? Saturday?